And the verifier is both independent and also connected to a tool like BIM 360, where you might be housing your models. So if you have a Revit file or an IFC file or a bunch of others, I think there are 80 different file formats that we can ingest. You simply either drag and drop them into the browser in the verify module and start to connect them up and verify that the work has been done. Or we can connect to BIM 360 and the models that are on BIM 360 or uploaded to BIM 360 are synchronized so that they can be connected and you don't have to upload them into multiple places. So let's move from the track now that we've got three tasks that are ready to be connected to the model deliverables. And in the verify step, we are going to, as I mentioned, you could drag and drop a model into here if it was any of those file formats, or we can connect directly into BIM 360 and making sure that the add-on has been created, has been added to BIM 360. That's a very important part of the workflow. So inside of your Autodesk account in the admin side, you need to add the Planoly app on that side so that it will allow you to connect and show your different projects so that you can have access to them. And let's go back. So then when you click into a project, we can then see the folder structure, the files, and whether they're models. And in this example, I'm the structural engineer. So I'm going to say this structural file. And the key is tying it to the individual deliverables rather than the aggregated model, because you're checking these things before you go and do something. In this example, we are checking for 3D coordination, and we're making sure that the model that has been created meets these requirements before we go and run a clash detection or coordination session. So here we can start to see there's two versions that have come through. We have the tree structure to understand what's in the model very quickly, very easily. And we also have all of the views. So it's, for example, the 2D view as well, and the 2D view being able to be interrogated as well, same principle. But let's look at it in the 3D view. And when we are ready for somebody to take a look at this, we're going to share the model and we are going to say, let me just filter the statuses for ready for review. So these were the tasks that I'm saying are ready for review. And the stairs are linked to this task here. The foundations are linked to this task here. So we've got two examples of tasks that are ready for review. And if we look now just at turning on the status of these tasks, you can see that the blue, let's show everything again. The blue represents elements that have been statused, that have been linked to tasks that are statused as ready for review. If I was to be now the manager, take my hat off from the reviewing and put the hat on as the manager, I would come into the environment, check the verify module and say, I'm going to take a look at the stairs. Maybe I'd use tools like the clustering tool to take them out of the building and understand them and identify them. You know, maybe there are certain requirements for the landings to be a certain size. Maybe there's certain parameters or properties that are required based on the requirements that we have defined. There's a whole bunch of other things that we can get into. We can also export the data from the scope and use it in tools like Solibri or other tools for model validation and verification and parts of the workflow that might be connected to Power BI and et cetera. Some really lots of fun things that you can do with this data. But once we are happy that this is good to go, then we can simply verify the task and you'll start to see elements that are turning green or to the color that have been chosen. And as we, let's show all, and let's throw those stairs back in the building, you'll start to see more and more of the model obviously turning green, and we can identify what the status is for elements as they go through. The ideal is that everything starts to become reviewed and green, and we have a model that if it's all green, it's ready to be published. So the version two, if this was the model where we had everything to a state that we wanted people to then have access to the model, we would publish the model and now they would have access to download that model or access it directly inside of BIM 360. A lot more to cover, you know, everything from measuring, cutting cross sections, navigating the model, et cetera. But I am sure you're pretty familiar with a lot of those features if you are using other 3D tools. So